So guys, in this opportunity, I want to share with you my experience learning Godot while making or recreating the Mario Bros. Game. I am not heard from Godot, so the basic things I know it is that I need to create the scenes. In this case, I will create three scenes. Maybe in the future, I will need more, maybe less. But first, the scenes that I will create will be the Mario scenes. The theory of Godot says that each scene could be had one or more nodes. So in this case, for Mario scenes, I will use three nodes: the area 2D node, the animated sprite node, the collision shape 2D node. Well, another scene that I will create will be World 1 scene, that is just the map of the world. I will use a sprite node, and that's it for this scene. The last thing that I will use will be level 001. That is kind of game manager scene, and in this scene I will call the Mario and World scenes. Okay, let's start with the first scene. First of all, I go to the scene menu, new scene, and then I drop it. An image or a sprite, there is the map of the world. Right now I will going to work with the Mario node. Previously I have editing the sprite because I have the sprite node here, and now I want to name scene, say a scene, and I will say a scene like Mario scene. In this part of the video, I will show you how I edit the image that I need to use as a frame of my animation. I use the gym, this sprite sheet I found on internet. This sprite sheet will be useful for me in order to add the frame for my animation. So I select the part of the image that I need in order to make the animation. I copy and paste as a new image in order to edit it. Mm-hmm. What I need to do right now is to erase the background because I need a transparent image. So I select the magic tool, I don't know what is the name. With this tool, I click on the pixel, and pixel of equals color in order to erase them. In that way, I get the image that I need for my animation. So, after that, I need to go to Godot. From Godot, I choose this tool, but I don't remember, I don't remember the name. Sorry, but it is a tool that let me put the image in frames in order to make it the animation. So what I need here is 3 frames. That's it. Right now, I will show you how to make the Chrome animation. First, I create an area 2D node. I call it Mario. Then, I create an animated sprite. Now, I call the animation as Chrome, and I change the name of the image in order to not get confused. Then I reopen my image with my frames, and then just I selected the frames. I change the speed scale in order to find the best speed for the animation. I create a new collision check to the node. That node will help me to detect the collision, to detect the collision with the shape. The last thing I created was the level 001. I created a general node, and I instantiated the Mario World Dash 1 hint. And I log the map object because I didn't want that to move. And the last thing I did was to save the scene, as I told you before, as level 0.001 because it will be like a game manager. So it is because that it will have this name of level 001. As this video doesn't have the intention to be a tutorial, I will explain quickly the script in Mario Node. The first function I will use is _process. This function is similar to the update function in Unity because it's called in every frame of the game. I create an action input and I call it move right to detect if the user or the player is pressing the right arrow keyboard. And then I check out if the velocity length is greater than 0. And it is that I play the animated sprite. Of course, I change the position of the sprite based on the velocity. Also, I should know if the player is pressing the left arrow in the keyboard in order to change the velocity in a negative way in order to move Mario to the left.